Way back in 2006, when I first decided to read the Bible, I came across the verse in Genesis 25, verse 20. The verse was about Rebecca, and Rebecca was described as young, beautiful, and old enough to get married. Aside from that, Rebecca also had a heart for service. So when I read that, I said to the Lord, "Lord, sana ganito yung maging asawa ko." A year later, I learned that Isaac was 40 years old. Since I was turning 40 years old at that time, this somehow became a reference verse for a wife.
Before I met Jonathan, I previously asked the Lord to confirm to me who my God's best was with four signs. The first sign was that my God's best should give me a Bible since God's word is important to me. The second sign was that he should not belong to a broken family and the entire family should go out together. The third sign was that his family should favor a relationship. And of course, the last sign was that he should wear eyeglasses since I'm attracted to men who wear glasses.
I first met Mabel around 2010. Around that time, nagkaroon ng Sunday school retreat. And Mabel approached me to ask something. When I saw her, somehow something struck me. Nung nakarating kami doon sa destination, tinanong ko isa sa mga kaibigan namin, si Ian. Tapos tinanong ko sa kanya, "Ian, sino yung babaeng yon?" Tapos ang sabi niya, yon, si Mabel yon. Tapos tinanong ko, "Meron na ba siyang boyfriend?" Tapos sabi niya, "Sorry, John, meron eh." Around 2011, one of my business partners, Mr. Shaw, who is also now my ninong, gave me two tickets to Mamma Mia. Binigyan niya ako ng ticket with a specific instruction na, "John, maghanap ka ng kasama mo."
I wanted so much to watch Mamma Mia because my uncle used to sing it to us when we were small.
2 weeks before the show, I again met with my partner, Mr. Shaw. So, during that time, tinanong niya sa akin, "John, meron ka na bang hanap na kasama?" Sabi ko, wala pa eh. Wala pa akong mahanap. Pero, God will provide. Actually, at that time, iniisip ko, either yung miss ko na lang or probably yung mom ko. During the week, napag-isipan ko ulit yung ticket. Tapos somehow, pumasok yung pangalan ni Mabel sa pangalan ko. So, ginawa ko, tinext ko si Ian, tapos tinanong ko kay Ian, "Ian, may boyfriend na ba si Mabel?"
I told him, "Single si Babs. Ano, gusto mo pag-pray ko na?"
Ko, "Sure, why not?" Pero sa isip-isip ko, as if parang meron naman mangyayari. Tapos, nung pag-uwi ko ng gabi na yon, tinignan ko ulit yung Mamma Mia ticket. Tapos somehow, gusto ko sanang padala kay Mabel. But after that, sabi ko, "Lord, ganito, ayokong mauna sa iyo and ayokong pagsisihan whatever yung gagawin ko." So, sabi ko, "Hindi ko papadala tong ticket na to kahit na masayang tong ticket na to. Ang hinihiling ko lang is, kung si Mabel talaga yung gusto mong makasama ko, then sana i-confirm mo sa akin before Sunday, kasi Sunday ko na lang siya makikita, at saka sana i-confirm mo sa akin through another person." That Saturday, pumunta ako sa CCF, tapos to attend a leadership conference. Tapos on the way home, I decided to pass by yung Sunday school office because at that day, during the week, birthday ni Teacher Bobby. So I wanted to greet her happy birthday. I decided to pass by yung Sunday school office to greet Teacher Bobby happy birthday. Tapos, so nung pagpasok ko, nagkwento-kwentuhan kami. Tapos afterwards, nung paalis na ako, sabi niya sa akin, "Ah, teka, John, halika muna dito. By the way, hindi ka na mag-iisa. Meron ka ng partner."
Then I saw Jonathan in church the next Sunday, and I told him, Jonathan, you're not going to be single for long anymore. I had a dream about you. I saw you in a dream, and you were with somebody.
Teka, Teacher Bobby, meron kasi akong isang pinagpipray. Pwedeng pakisabi sa akin kung sino yon. Tapos, binulong niya sa akin, sabi niya, si Mabel. So, tapos sabi ko, Teacher Bobby, kailan mo napaniginipan yon? Tapos sabi niya sa akin, Thursday ng gabi. Yun yung same night na nag-text ako kay Ian at tinanong ko about kay Mabel kung single pa siya o hindi. Yun yung same night na nag-pray si Ian at saka nag-pray din ako. The next day, linagay ko yung Mamma Mia ticket sa isang envelope tapos pinigay ko kay Teacher Bobby para ibigay kay Mabel. After that, nung Sunday evening, tinanong ko kay Teacher Bobby, oh, Teacher Bobby, nakuha na ba ni Mabel yung ticket?
I received a text from Teacher Bobby telling me someone left something for me. I felt a little bit nervous because she said it was urgent.
Nung Sunday ng gabi, tinanong ko kay Teacher Bobby, Teacher Bobby, nakuha ba ni Mabel yung ticket? Tapos sabi niya sa akin, John, hindi pumasok si Mabel eh. Hindi ko nabigay yung ticket. So during the week, hindi ni Mabel nakuha yung ticket. No, nung pagdating ng Friday morning, nung nagbabasa ako ng Bible, nabasa ko Psalm 25 verse 3. At ang nakasulat doon is, no one who trusts in the Lord will ever be disgraced. So sabi ko, Lord, kung sa iyo talaga to, then mangyayari yung whatever yung sinabi mo. Makukuha ni Mabel yung ticket.
That gave me the small envelope from Teacher Bobby. When I opened it, I immediately saw the Mamma Mia ticket.
The following day, nag-meet kami ni Mabel at nanood kami ng Mamma Mia. After ng show, nag-dinner kami ni Mabel. Habang nag-uusap kami, na-realize ko lahat ng hinahanap ko, lahat ng hinihingi ko kay Lord for my future wife na sa kanya.
It's always been a mystery to me how two hearts can come together and love can last forever.
2 weeks later, pumunta ako sa Timberland to seek God's confirmation about Mabel. At that time, ang binabasa ko sa Bible was 1 Samuel 25. So, ang ginawa ko, nag-pray ako kay God. Tapos, nung binuksan ko yung Bible ko, nag-continue ako sa 1 Samuel 25. Ngayon, yung Bible ko, electronic Bible siya. So, meron akong nakitang isang note doon. Meron akong nakitang isang icon doon sa Bible. Tapos, nung clinic ko siya, pumunta siya sa Genesis 24:67. Tapos, at that time, yun yung time na pinakasalan ni Isaac si Rebecca. So, after reading that verse, alam ko na si Mabel yung magiging future wife ko.
On March 4, John asked me to meet with him at podium and told me to pray about us. I started wondering if he could be my future partner or my God's best, as Christians call it. I was determined to make sure I won't make the wrong decisions for my partner this time around. Back to my checklist on April 2012, John visited me and gave me a Bible. I was shocked. At first, I don't want to accept it. I told God, Lord, are you sure? He's too old. I know I wanted someone older, but parang nasobrahan ata. John kept insisting that I take it, so reluctantly, I took it. Then, on Mother's Day, John invited me to have lunch with the family. At first, some family members could not make it. However, by God's grace, everyone was able to show up and the family member was complete. In addition, I found favor with the family, and they warmly accepted me. Then on May 20, 2012, John invited me to go to Timberland to pray to God. That day, God led me to read the book of Ruth. It was interesting that our Bible study group, the topic was called Lady-in-Waiting. It focused on Ruth's character. As I was reading the passage, this verse struck me as I remembered how Jonathan noticed me in one event and asked Ian if I belonged to someone else already. I didn't know about it until he told me, and I began backtracking my memory during that time. God orchestrated things to happen similar to Ruth in the scripture.
I promise that wherever you may go, wherever life may lead you, with all my heart I'll be there too. And from this moment on, I want you to know.
After God's confirmation, I kept telling Mabel to ask God about us. So I kept on following her up kung meron siyang narinig kay God.
He's been so consistent and eager to know if I have confirmation already from God about his partner for me. I also asked Teacher Bobby about John, and she likewise showed favor.
When she consulted her Bible study leader, she also showed favor for us. Then we had dinner with my spiritual father, Mr. Shaw, and she also showed favor with us.
I realized that Jonathan is God's gift to me.
I realized Mabel was God's best friend.
You must have heard everything.